Hello, chat. Happy Sunday, as always. I see DCB should be popping in a moment. There's Triss. Hello, Kevi. Hello, Vox. Hello, people. I popped the link in a couple different chats to see who would show up this time. We'll see. Savannah should be popping in later. Fortunately, although we are going to get right into the game because I don't want another 35 minutes spent on preamble this time, I have to go play with the physical connection of the adapter piece that I'm using to power the entire streaming setup into the wall because loose receptacles, yet again, strike, ruining my stream right as I'm about to stream. So that's phenomenal. How's everyone doing, though? I should mention that this might be the last Sunday stream. Possibly. I'll have to see what my schedule is going forwards because potentially going to be employed again come next Friday, and if not, certainly in the next month. Something has to fucking take me, you know? So, I don't know what my schedule for work was going to look like. Maybe that's a blessing in disguise because I feel like Sunday evenings are a little bit of an odd time slot to fill for streams. I don't know. People are enjoying them, and some people show up. I just wonder if I could potentially get more people to show up if I was streaming at a different time, you know? So, I'll keep everyone posted. Maybe I'll do like a community post or something to let folks know what we're doing as far as the streams go. But we're going to move right into the game because again, I don't want it to look up and suddenly, oh, we're 35 minutes in and I haven't even gotten to Sly, because these chapters of Sly are starting to run pretty long. Okay, I've moved the mic across the room. I'm going to try to get the fucking thing to stay in the wall, please. That would be nice. Technical problems. Gotta love it. Alright, hold on. Oh! Okay, there we go. That fixed it. transition. Good, good. It seems like physically turning my heater onto its side helps to keep it in better. I have to figure out a way to keep that in the wall. I could go back to using a power strip. I kind of don't want to, because it's a lot more garbage to keep around. Disk. Get the disk in there. Get the chat pulled up on the phone. All that good stuff. How you guys doing? How's your Sunday been? What's funny is that even though I intentionally don't want to do a ton of preamble, I actually do have something that I could show off. Maybe if there's still time by the end, we'll see how quickly this chapter of Sly goes. We're right in the middle of the game here, so, If we got time, maybe I'll show it off, because it's coming out really cool. Although I would have to completely change up my streaming setup in OBS to be able to accommodate that. I would just be adding it as another source, but you know, let me not make it sound crazier than it is. There we go. Extremely adequate is definitely the way that I would describe it. Describe my Sunday. It has been a strange, like, 2 weeks, if I'm being perfectly honest. But I was thinking as we were doing the last stream, I'm like, I'm really not on the ball tonight. Let me go ahead and give them something a little more animated to listen to. But like I said, we are on to the next chapter. If you don't remember, last one was the first one of Prague, where we were taking on the Contessa, who finally captured the Cooper gang. And now that they're all free, and she's hiding out in her palatial estate in also Prague, presumably. XP is very much the netbook OS, absolutely. Oh God, hold on. Sorry.
Castle Estate.
Hold on. It's a well Let's restart fortified. That. Because I just realized that I had the video capture device muted, which is not ideal. If you're trying to listen to the actual game. I'll make sure that... Unfortunately, I've said this multiple times, I have no way of monitoring myself while we're going. So, audio problems, I don't know about unless chat tells me, and chat never tells me. That's okay, though. Alright. Yep, okay. Excellent. Phenomenal. Just says, editing people out of black and white photos is as difficult as redrawing what's behind the person you're editing out. This is not a problem that I often find myself facing, but I can imagine.
Time for a little payback. The Contessa, having escaped us into prison, is now hiding out in her castle estate. It's a well-fortified gothic nightmare that would make any thief run in terror. Terrible or not, that's where we're headed. To sweeten the deal, we've learned that the Contessa, who until recently was a secret member of the Claw Gang, is in possession of the Clockwork Eyes. The Thievius Raccoonus describes the eyes stopping opponents dead in their tracks, transfixed in their gaze. It doesn't take a genius to figure out what an accomplished hypnotist could do with such powerful artifacts. News of the Contessa's corruption has spread to Interpol. Constable Neela, being closest to the case, was granted a cash allowance to hire an army of local mercenaries. It looks like we're walking into a full-scale war. But we have to act now, before things go from bad to worse.
Alrighty. Go ahead and turn the game down so I'm not competing with it. Not by a ton, but enough that I'm not going to be competing with it. Clockwork is a funky villain. He's, his whole thing is quite literally, he's become a machine, and apparently those parts are still kind of alive, sort of, somehow. Furry technology. Alright. Hop onto this rooftop. Oh yeah, there's tanks, by the way, which is really funny. You can hop on the tank, and as long as you don't get into their direct line of sight, they can't see you, which is great. Alright, let's see what we got going on. We're shaking.
Okay, here's the plan. First, take some recon photos around the area. Then make your way up to the re-education tower.
Looks pleasant enough.
Oh, and stay clear of tanks. You know, so you don't get blown up into little sticky pieces.
That would definitely disturb Bentley. Alright. This, by the way, outside of France, probably has my favorite music in the entirety of Sly. It's awesome. Alright, I should be able to take a picture of this boat in a moment. Yep. Boat.
The Contessa has these boats out on patrol against Nayla's army. They could be useful to hitch a ride.
That just makes me think of Venice. Which we will get to in a couple streams. Oops. Do I have time? Can I do this? I can. Alright, I'm definitely not getting a shot from there. I should be able to right here. There we go.
Neela's made a headquarters out of that old bank.
You know what's funny too is that I find the most random things as I'm just like idly clicking around online, and there was this band called Boat, and their whole thing was like, they had this album cover that was like spoofing other albums, like famous albums, And replacing, like, all of the, like, band names with their name, which was just Boat. I think it was Boat. Might have been Boats, but I'm pretty sure the band name was just Boat, which is easily the best band name that's ever been conceived. Oh, fuck. I've been spotted. Oh, no. Alright. Whoops. Can I buy the paraglider yet? I see it. Hold on. How much money do I have? Because I'm tempted. I have, like, almost 1,400 points. Alright, screw it. We're going to just redo the mission in a moment. I'm going to buy the paraglider, because that shit seriously comes in handy. And I imagine I still have some nice jewelry that I have not pawned off. Yep. Alright. Yes, thank you. God, the best upgrade in the entire goddamn game is the paraglider. The best. Yeah, that's also a good one. Fortunately, Bentleys are too expensive. Maybe later. Alright. Paraglider. This power-up does not need to be assigned to a button. R1. That was it. So R1. Oh, yeah. Tell me that isn't badass. That was kind of a shitty jump, but that's okay. I mean, to be fair, isn't everything Bentley has a gadget?
Make your way up to the re-education tower.
Looks pleasant enough.
Oh, and stay clear of tanks. You know, so you don't get blown up into little sticky pieces.
Alright. So now, seriously, that paraglider's awesome. Alright. Whoops. Alright, that was close.
Nila's made a headquarters out of that old bank. It's a pretty secure location.
See, I love that description because I'm like, what would disturb Bentley more? His friend being blown up or the fact that the pieces are sticky? Oh shit, be quick.
The Contessa has these boats out on patrol against Nila's army. They could be useful to hitch a ride.
Alright, get out of there. Nope. See you later. Alright. So now, should be able to... Oh yeah. Awesome. What cool gadgets. I pass by the wolves, my dog starts barking. He's not in the room with me. He has no idea that I'm fighting werewolves, but that's a pretty funny coincidence. Probably. Maybe. Oh shit, the tanks are red. No, get fucked. He wants to fight the werewolves too. He would run away from the werewolves. He is not a brave dog. In the slightest. Alright. Now... Can I stand on this? I can't... Sly! Listen. I don't know if you guys have ever been in a studio. We're talking, like, these kind of, like, flash pot lights. They're so unbelievably hot. Especially given that they're, like, it's a gigantic metal bulb. And then... a gigantic bulb in a metal casing. And he could just stand on it, no problem. Sherlock, if you don't know, Sherlock is one of Kebby's guinea pigs. Sherlock is insane and has absolutely no fear response whatsoever. She does not care. There are certain survival instincts that guinea pigs have, and Sherlock prefers to ignore them completely. Ah, camera got stuck. There we go. Don't you love mid-2000s game camera follies?
What else do we need to take a picture of? Oh, we passed by one of them. Oh, the blimp. The blimp. Here we go. Get a good shot of that blimp.
That's the blimp the Contessa used to escape from the prison. Maybe we could use it to our advantage around all these high towers.
Oh, come on. Why did you hop on that spire, but not the hook? The one that's right next to you. It's true. She's so menacing. Thank you. Very cool. No! Stalk a child. Alright. And now we need a shot of the tank. Apparently we can't just pick any tank. It's gotta be that tank. I love that he hesitates every single time he says the re-education tower. He's so... It's so menacing. Although, to be fair, yes it is. Whoops. Bentley's like, I already know everything. I don't need to be re-educated. Here we are. Here's that tower. Also, yeah, for whatever strange... Oops, I didn't realize this exploded. Neat. For whatever reason, all of Gibby's guinea pigs are, like, huge. Like, they're huge. There's no other way to put it. She just raises big guinea pigs. Why do I keep hitting them? They explode. Yeah, there's the tower. Alright, everyone. Let's see what's inside.
Try working your way around to the tower's window.
Yeah, I mean, that's what Sly does, yep. Alright, going in. They're just gigantic. They're huge. Enlarge your guinea pig.
Bentley, there's more than just the clockwork eyes up here.
I know she's in mortal danger.
Why are you doing this? Neela, she set me up. I'm an honest cop.
Of course you are. I've read your psychological profile. I know that you're honest.
Then why are you doing this to me?
Because, dear, you're honest. You see, by chasing after Sly Cooper, you learned too much about the Claw Gang and its spice operation. It was only a matter of time before you figured out that I was a secret member. So, when Neela gave me a chance to put you in custody, I took it.
Coward. You're a disgrace to Interpol. I'll make it my life's work.
This is why Bentley was antsy about the re-education tower. I mean, oh man. You know somebody on the team was gleeful that they could, you know, chain up their waifu for this level.
I won't be brainwashed that easily.
Quite right. It won't be easy or painless. But I will reprogram your mind and you will take the fall for me at Interpol. Now, just lay back and relax. Go
That's
to
gay.
Your happy place. And stay there forever.
I don't think they've seen you. Take a few photos and get out of there.
No. I've got to help Carmelita. She's in trouble here.
There's nothing you can do now. Get the recon photos and come back to the safe house. I swear, we'll find a way to help her.
All right. Hold on, I gotta get the perfect shot.
Inspector Fox is restrained in an old Iron Tech 250. Crude, but effective.
Why does he know the name of that?
The clockwork eyes! They seem to be routed through that code.
This is so silly. It's too silly. So silly. Like, Carly looked like she's enjoying that. Again, somebody was like, yee, I can chain up my waifu. You know, for game reasons, of course.
Tough is too sissy a word to describe those guys.
There you go. I like Trista's take on it. That's his side hustle.
That's a mind shuffler. I didn't think they were real. It's made of equal parts science and black magic. Indestructible to conventional weapons.
Cool. I don't see where the last thing I'm supposed to take a picture of is. Is it what she's typing on? Where's this old terminal? Oh, it's right here. That's it.
That old terminal should be hardwired to the systems in this tower. We need to find a way to get it online. All right, head back to the safe house and we'll get a plan together.
We always get a plan together.
Between Neela and Contessa has put the castle on high alert. Yet at the clockwork eyes, we'll just subtly manipulate this conflict to our advantage. Here's the plan. Murray, sneak into the castle and kidnap the head of security. I want to ask him a few questions. Meanwhile, Sly and I are going to get a little paranormal. I'll slip into the crypts beneath the castle and put together a bad mojo pop. It should be enough to destroy the mind shuffler. Sly, you capture a few local ghosts and drop them into Neela's headquarters. Hopefully the near-death experience will inspire her to purchase more mercenary firepower. We've all got our assignments. Good luck.
All right. It's fucking time. My friends. Who do I want to play as first? What do I have to do as Bentley? What Bentley stuff? Yes. Alright. Let's do a Bentley thing. I am quite partial to the mixture of, like, science and black magic, though. That's pretty neat. Alright. We gotta put some moves. See you later. That I'm never gonna blow up. I'm just gonna keep fucking alerting everybody. Oh wait, hold on. Boom. I'm a genius. Aww, he had to stretch up to reach the keypad. It's cute.
She'd have a bad mojo collector to transport the overflow.
Huh?
It's a semi-magical device.
He's a little guy. He's such a silly little guy.
I need it to gather the runoff from these spouts.
Wow, sounds easy.
Not really. Bad mojo is a powerfully dark force. Take any damage while carrying that collector and you're done for.
Wow, sounds hard.
Yes, it presents an interesting tactical challenge. Perhaps I could use the death traps native to these crypts against any foe that might attempt to thwart my collection of the ectoplasm.
Huh? No way that'll work. I'd use that switch to smash up the guards before they ever got near me.
Precisely. Once all four cylinders of the collection device...
I don't know if he has little man issues. I think he uses it to his advantage. I can relate.
Still not online.
Oh, this is violent. Holy shit. Yo. I swear, like, last stream I was talking about playing Mad World. I guess I am. This is brutal! Wow. It's a good thing it's all got, like, 60s Batman sounds, or else I might think it's, like, super fucked up or something. This is a lot of fun, though. Maybe I should use this for a Quake map or something. I love when you can use environmental traps to take out monsters in Quake.
Run out of bad mojo. No matter, I'm 1/4 of the way to a full tank.
All right, deeper in we go. Do tell, Kebby. Do tell. Aw, Murray, you're so smart. Let's use the rooftops. I feel like that's probably safer. At the very least, if something tries to, you know, mess with me, I can just, you know, kick it off the cliff. There we go. Much better. Use that head of yours, Cammy.
Hey, look! The link worked. That's impressive.
Okay, round two of being utterly violent to these freaking mooks. Holy shit. That is so brutal. That's a lot of fun. I think this is one of my favorite missions. Doink. See you later. Like, that's awesome. God, I gotta hit somebody with the knives. Hold on. That was a close one.
Need more time.
Oh, this is like in Tempest. If you let the enemies in Tempest get to the top of the web, you're screwed. There's really no way to take care of them. There we go. You get a super zapper, but like, it's not especially effective. This'll hurt. He's enjoying this. I guess it really is his side hustle. Oh. Fuck.
Hello, vampire. Welcome to the chat.
Fuck. This is... Okay, come on. We can do this. I just have to keep up with the heat.
That's just not safe.
That's just not safe. Maybe it will. This seems to be the trap that resets the quickest, so I guess I should just sit on this one. I have no clue how you get anything with the knives. That's okay. This really is satisfying, though. Like, it should not be this much fun to, like, kill things violently, but it is. This'll hurt. Oh, fuck.
Come on, come on!
Ah, shit. That's right, that's right. Get him, doggies. Bark. Come on. Damn it. Come on, we got this. We got this. I just gotta keep on it. Set already. Jesus. Cool.
I'm so sorry. It's still resetting.
Maybe I have to use my crossbow to use it. Fuck.
Come the fuck on.
These traps don't reset fast enough. Maybe I just have to use the bombs occasionally. That might be it. Might have to give that a shot. Come on. Wow, whole 7 people watching me fuck this mission up. It's all good. This is tricky. Alright, come on. Focus. Timing probably plays a role. Probably. Oh, wait. I can knock him into the spikes. That's not bad.
It's not ready yet.
First try. First try, let's go. Alright, come on. Seriously, where is the sweet spot for this other attack? Hold on. I'm gonna take one intentionally to fuck up. There we go, right when they're there. So it's a last resort attack. Okay. Yeah, okay. That's okay, I got that. There we go. Alright. I probably wasn't making it particularly easy for myself not using this extra trap. But, like, I didn't know where the sweet spot was as far as actually hitting it.
So sorry.
There we go. Now we got the rhythm. Okay. Alright, come on. I got this is it. This is the run. This is the run. I got this.
Eight physics.
Got this, come on. Yeah, if you time it right, you can get that pendulum with two guys. Just that. Wait, check it. Nope. Oh, that was close.
Watch out!
I really overthought that. Wow. Yeah. Come on. Almost there. We got our mojo working now, boys.
Excellent! Another chamber in my mojo collector is full. Moving on to the third crypt.
All right. We got one half the backpack filled. We got this. Yep, I see him. Perfect. Overthinking is indeed our specialty.
That shit puts him to sleep.
I have no idea how I'm supposed to effectively wield these traps. We'll give it a shot, though.
Touché.
That sucked. That's pretty cool. What about this one? Another crusher. Oh, yeah. How long does it take for the trap to reset? Hurry up! What the fuck? Why did it take so long? Sorry, just run around the chamber for a moment. Wait, it's... There we go. go. Now it's reset. Thank you. Thank you. Very cool. Hurry up! Fuck. First try. Okay. I love that they just fall asleep like that. EP gas.
Sorry about that.
Wait, they actually crumble into stone. Did you see that? You let them on fire, and it's not like they, like, perish in fire. They crumble into dust. That's funky. Come on, there has to be one trap I can use. Come on. Ooh, bombs. Duh. My main form of attack. See? They literally crumble into dust and die like that. Some of the deaths in this game are kind of toony, and then other ones are just, like, horribly violent. It's pretty interesting. Oh, wait! And then you bomb them! Yeah!
Harry Strike!
Yeah! Yeah! I have no clue why there's such violent death traps in these crypts, but I appreciate it nonetheless.
That does it for this room. Looks like I've only got one more crypt to go.
Oh, it's true. There you go. It's like getting customers in the door, but instead of customers, it's corpses. I like that. Savannah, welcome. I'm very glad that you can make it. It's always sad when you have to miss a Sly stream. Because, you know, this is... I don't want to say our game, but it's our game. I will say... I've kind of had this, like... inability to, come up with shit to talk about on stream the last couple weeks. Which is strange. Like, you know, usually when I have, like, my rambles, it just sort of, my mind goes blank instead. It's been weird. Alright, now what do all of these traps do? Wow. Yeah, drown that fucking werewolf.
Sorry about that.
He's not sorry at all. Oh, fuck. Okay, what do we got? Sorry, chat exploded. I gotta read this. So we got a caramel latte, which is tasty. I mean, if that's the issue with Win log on, then I would do that, DCB. And much appreciated, because Canada. For those of you who don't know, Savannah is from Canada. So, much appreciated. Stock the child.
Painful.
Ooh. He fell through the open platform. That's funny. That's like something I would see in, like, Battle for Bikini Bottom. Oh, God.
This'll hurt.
Okay. So you're hopping in the middle one. You have to, like, anticipate their movements a little bit. I was about to say, this one feels like it would be the easiest because you just knock them into the water. But nothing is ever easy. I just gotta make it to that button. There we go, thank God. Boom.
First try. I'm the diversity hire.
Savannah missed that glorious, 10 minutes that I spent on the one with the pendulum. And by 10 minutes, I mean I got it first try, because, you know, I'm awesome at video games like that. Alright, that's a slide job. Whoops. There goes the neighborhood. Awoo. Right between the lines. That's how we do it. I was saying, Savannah, that I feel like of all of the music in this game, I think this, obviously nothing tops France, but I think this probably has, like, my second favorite overworld theme. It's just so cool sounding. Dark. I love the really deep pianos. That part's really cool. All right.
Back to the safe house.
Let's do Sly next. Because where he is already in view. And we got the paraglider also, finally. Whoop. Nope, you saw nothing. See? Saw nothing. See you later.
Alright, Sly. There's your new objective. Sneak inside and smash the coffin of the evil wolf priestess.
Wolf priestess.
Does the old girl really deserve that sort of treatment?
Weren't you listening? She was an evil wolf priestess. Once you smash the coffin, it'll free all the ghosts trapped in there with her.
Okay, I don't know where you're going with all of this, but freeing trapped ghosts sounds vaguely heroic.
Listen, he correctly identified a water tower as a giant death robot. I think we should maybe listen to Bentley here. See, I'm used to climbing on stuff, maybe not moving stuff. There we go. I swear, I see raccoons. Maybe.
Nice work.
I'm told that they exist. Alright, there we go. I don't know what she needed all those ghosts for. I know she was an evil wolf priestess, but you can't take it with you when you die.
I modified the imager in your binoculars to capture ghosts.
Didn't I just set these guys free? Why would I want to capture them again?
Not to worry. It's only a short-term confinement. Gather all the ghosts, then set them free down the chimney of Neela's headquarters.
Shit down Neela's chimney? Attack from the based.
Correct. If I did my math right, and I always do my math right, Neela should respond to the assault by purchasing more firepower.
Anything bad for the Contessa is good for us. And we get to really freak out Neela.
That sucks. Oh yeah, I finally got the paraglider. I'm so happy. This game gets so annoying to fucking navigate without the paraglider. Nope. Nope, now he's gone. There he is. Come on. I do like that he's a skeleton ghost. That's pretty cool. I don't know why he would. I figured that ghosts would look like what you did, you know, in life. Maybe the slide team, when they weren't, you know, tying Carmelita out, were like, Kebby, where she feels bad when we just come up with a design and then, like, we don't, like, name it or anything. Like we were gonna do with Pennyverse that one time. See? He kind of, you know what he looks like? He looks like Dry Bones. That's what he looks like. Hold on. That's what he reminds me of. He looks like Dry Bones. Maybe they were skeletons in life. I'm sure. In this world of people with flesh, that ghost skeletons are real. I'm sure. There we go. The ghosts of the people's skeletons. See, I've heard pee is stored in the balls. I have never heard souls are stored in the bone marrow. That's a new one on me. No, the bone marrow has its own soul. This is phenomenal lore. I am listening and learning. Oh, it took me a moment to realize what Dunmeshi meant. That's a manga that Kevi has been obsessed with. Not that that's a bad thing, because I'm just glad to see anime that isn't porn, frankly. Turns out, when it's written by a woman, you have a greater chance of it not being pornography. And it's pretty good, too, so. At least what I've seen of it, so.
What you're referring to as souls in the bone marrow is actually souls slash bone marrow, or as I like to call it, souls plus bone marrow.
Okay. Alright. I have to resist the urge not to smack the barrels again. Resist the urge to smack the barrels again. Because I was also, that's another thing that you missed, Savannah. I was doing that earlier. And perhaps it was not the smartest idea, given that they fucking explode. Asshole duck. Oh, there's a ghost. Come on. He's a vulture. He's literally right in the center of my binoculum. Let's come on. Ugh. Apparently, by the way, it was just Bat Appreciation Day, I just appreciated the shit out of that bat. There we go. Whoops. That was close. We really gotta go back and get all the bottles at some point. Maybe I'll make that like a... I mean, here's the thing. I was about to say maybe I'll make it like a bonus stream. But I'm like, man, I'm sure some of those gadgets would have been like useful during the game. But like, we're already to halfway through it. So, you know. So, I mean, I'm sure it would still come in handy. But I feel like the window for these, whatever you get out of these bottles to actually matter, is rapidly closing. You, would you like to be in an area I can photograph? Yeah. I mean, to be fair, if you were a ghost, would you want people taking pictures of you? You're like, I'm already in a very compromised position here. My bone marrow is completely exposed. Sorry, the soul in my bone marrow is completely exposed. A little dignity. Maybe don't take my picture. It's like that R.E.M. song. He doesn't even have pants. He didn't have any clothes on. Boyo is totally, like, just raw dogging. Nope, see you later. Nope, I wasn't just here. Nope, sorry. Oh, get the fuck out of here. Nope, sorry, see you later. Yeah, you're just sly, I guess. Listen, when you are a master thief, freeballing is part of the technique. That's what I've learned in all of my years of playing these games. Sly, more like completely fucking exposed. Shit. There he is. Decided he wants a peek at restrained Carmelita. I have accidentally used freeballin' in a professional setting before. I'm sure there is at least one person that you have worked with in your life, in like a remote setting, who was not at the time wearing pants. So, they got it. They appreciated it. I'm sure. I do like that there's vultures walking around, and there's also, I think that's a bird. Does he fly away? Yeah, he flies away. So we have walking birds, and then also just birds. Shout out to the L3 button, by the way. Oh, yeah. Yeah, but I guess the weird part is it's like, you expect there to be the separation, right? Of like, certain species are, like, are sapient and others aren't. But it's just weird to see like, birds, and then also other birds. It'd be like if there were, like, non-anthrobats. I will get right on that, Triss, I promise. Totally.
The Goofy versus Pluto debate. He has developmental disability.
I've never heard this. I don't get out much. Sometimes I ponder getting out even less, if I'm honest. Okay, whatever. That was kind of what I was trying to do anyway. That's fine. For legal reasons, for reasons of governmental importance, Savannah is not associated with the stream where Bentley has been edited into photos as Hitler. That is a legal disclaimer. You can use that in court.
Okay, Sly. You have all the ghosts. Now just make your way to Neela's HQ and drop them down her chimney.
That's right. We're dropping them down in her chimney. Let's go! okay. All right. It's just such a viscerally disgusting idea. It's phenomenal. Alright, where are we at? Climb all the way to the top, right? Right there. Alright, 3, 2. Oh man, I wish this was a Murray mission, because Murray has that move where he goes like that. That would have been perfect.
No trousers, easy dumps and chimneys.
There you go.
So the Contessa wants war, eh? Perhaps it's time I purchase a little air power. A few bombers should put that old charlatan in her place.
Totally legit accent, by the way. Totally. Oh god. You know what I'm reminded of suddenly? This is the absolute worst fucking thing in the history of cinema. The first Alvin and the Chipmunks movie, right? And this was used in the trailers. They were like, this is what we need to advertise our movie based on. You might already know what I'm talking about. It's the scene where, I'm trying to remember which of the two chipmunks. I think Alvin wasn't involved. I think it was it Simon who was eating Theodore's poo? And he's like, it's a raisin, Dave. Like, I don't know. I as a kid, I was like, why did you put this in the movie? As an adult, I'm like, why did you put this in the movie? Hilarity for the whole family, I'm sure.
It was, yeah,
it was, okay, yeah. See, here's the thing, right? If I didn't know any better, if I was a more naive sort, more naive than I actually am, I would have assumed that somebody on the writing staff for Alvin and the Chipmunks put that in there on purpose. And the only reason I think that is because I know exactly what happens in the cartoon industry.
The stories of,
it was like, Cartoon Network literally has a rule. There cannot be any plots of cartoons that involve characters in diapers. Because there was a guy, I think, what was his name? Vincent Waller, I want to say? But he's you know, a long-term veteran of writing for these cartoons. He's worked on SpongeBob, he worked on Ren and Stimpy, like all this shit. And he just continued every single show, put in an episode where they wore diapers. And I'm just like, I'm so not surprised. Also, I'm very sad that I watched that as a child. Just figured I'd mention that, since it has recently come to mind. As recently as this stream. But yeah, no, they put some weird shit in cartoons, dude. And they put some weird shit in games too, don't get me wrong. But it's like, it's almost charming when you see like, oh, you know, Carmelita, she's you know, busty and, you know, big. And it feels vaguely more innocent than like somebody's bizarro world diaper kink is being shown to children. I don't know, dude. I'm getting too old for this shit.
Yeah. And weird shit.
Oh my god, iCarly, dude. I am so beyond not surprised. I don't know if she's actually officially come out. I think she had a book, Jeanette McCurdy. I feel like she had a book about that stuff. I don't quite recall. But I do know that there's a reason that she does not participate in any of that anymore. There's a very good reason for that. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Like, thankfully, it's at least come out. You know? Like, it's not... You know, people have to suffer alone with that knowledge. Yeah. Shit. I kind of want to see that. I mean, don't get me... I mean, I'm already paying attention to a bunch of shit, right? Like, I was going down the rabbit hole of the fucking, the shit about pink-pilling boys, boy kisser and stuff like that. I was going down that rabbit hole. I'm like, man... What the fuck? Shit makes gay people look fucking awful. I take offense. As a gay man, I take offense. Keep your fucking kids off the internet. Just saying. Signed, somebody who was groomed at 14.
Apparently it's viscerally upsetting. Okay, maybe I don't want to watch it then, to be perfectly honest.
Because... I've heard the allegations, and they're already pretty upset. And if there's, like, actual, like, I don't know.
They're not even allegations.
Yeah, keep your kids out of the entertainment industry. I'm genuinely impressed. Whenever there's a story of, like, one of these kids who apparently was in touch, I'm, like, genuinely impressed. I'm like, holy shit. Either some good-ass parenting or some phenomenal luck.
Yeah.
Jesus. I'm so not surprised that there were actual arrests made.
Hey, Murray, can you see the general from there?
And then continued to work with kids. Jesus fucking Christ.
Don't let his appearance fool you. That's General Clawfoot. And he's one of the toughest old soldiers you'll ever see. Not to mention head of castle security.
What if he doesn't want to come? I don't want to hurt him.
Oh, don't worry about that. He's only afraid of two things. Fire and water. Other than that, you couldn't hurt him if you wanted to. He might even come in handy along the way. As a projectile.
Wow. That is handy.
That's right. We're just going to throw an old man at guards. Let's go. Hey, motherfucker. Doink. Get a nice good look at him. He appears to be wearing a toga, which is what you wear when you're head of castle security. Of course. Fuck out of here. Oh god. Where'd he go? I just knocked him off a cliff. I don't know where he went. Ow. Oh, there he is. Hey, alright, listen. You want some? You want war? You got it. Motherfuckers. Where'd the general go? Oh, he's walking away.
He's just walking away!
He's so chill about it. He's just like, fucking kids these days. Doink. Nope, you're coming with me, old man. I like that he's not even trying to, like, get in attention. Like, you know, hey, I was just almost kidnapped. He's just like... I'm old. I've seen some shit. I just want to go back to my, I don't know, cave? He's a bat, right? I guess he's in a cave. Oh, shit. Nope. See you later. This might jeopardize the mission slightly. Alright, thank God. Don't be bat racist. Come on, Grandpa. We gotta get you to bed. So I've been bird racist, I've been bat racist. I've completely lost my way to the safe house. I needed the help. You know, someday I'm gonna be as good as Jake. Oh, maybe I should pay attention. That would help. God damn. Where'd the general go? There's something kind of special, by the way, about just listening to, like, your PS2 grinding away as you play. Working as hard as you do, it's probably a little better at its job than I am at playing video games, but we do our best. Oh yeah, he's great. He's that's great. We're struggling together. That's the message that I want to bring onto this stream. Unity. And punching the shit out of vultures. Alright, where's the general? I love it, because you can't even really fail this mission. He just kind of, like, continues wandering. Okay, there he is. He's up there. Come on! I need cut-rate auto insurance. You're coming with me. Oh my god. I was like, fall off the fucking building. Arsenoi sweep, legit, Dunstack! No. Are we getting closer? Am I walking away from the safe house? There it is.
He's like an Alzheimer's patient.
I'm surprised Triss has not mentioned the, oh god. The fact that he is, speaking bizarro German the entire time. Maybe this is World War II. I don't know why he sounds German. I mean, I guess we are in the, oh god. That worked out really nicely. I didn't even mean for that. Oh, shit. Nope. Sorry. See you later. And there we go. Prague is basically German.
Well, well, General Clawfoot. We've got a lot to talk about. You wouldn't by chance know the security code to the castle gates, hmm? Don't feel like talking, huh? How about a little of this?
Jack!
Talk, you scoundrel!
Well, there you go. Bentley commits more war crimes.
All right, fellas. Let's get down to business. The first steps to escalating the war between Neela and the Contessa have gone well. We're down to the final setups before we spring our trap. Sly, I need you to steal a voice modulator from the castle and install it under Neela's headquarters. If all goes as planned, it should allow us to give orders to her mercenaries without being detected. Unfortunately, Neela's recent bomber purchase has made her army overenthusiastic, and they might strike before we're ready. Which leads me to Murray. I need you to hotwire one of the Contessa's tanks and go to town on the mercenaries. We just need to intimidate them a little. And finally, I'll venture back into the crypts to power up that old computer in the re-education tower. We're going to need it to save Carmelita. Oh, and Sly, if you haven't already got one, you'll need to buy a paraglider for the heist. Okay, let's move out.
All right. So there's no slime missions, so we're doing... Bentley loves saying re-education. Yeah! We were talking about that earlier. He's just got a thing for it. Alright. Who's ready to hotwire a goddamn tank? See, Murray isn't so dumb after all. Nope, you're not fucking this up for me.
Murray, use both analog sticks to drive the tank. Press both up to move forward, both down to go in reverse, and in opposite directions to rotate. To fire your turret, tap the R1 button. You'll need to take out 6 tanks to get the job done.
Oh my god, literal tank controls.
Okay, guys, I'm in a tank.
Based. The Murray is in a tank.
Remember, all sticks up to move forward, both down for reverse, and in opposite directions to rotate. The R1 button fires your turret.
Oh, this is just like Battle Zone. This is literally, man, first fucking, first Robotron, now Battle Zone. Awesome. These guys love their classic arcade games. Me too. Maybe a little bit of Missile Command in there too, with some of the
India missions.
Me when I'm in a tank. Tank! Tank! You know, maybe it would help if I could steer. Turn! Motherfucker needs to learn how to drive a tank. That motherfucker is neat. Here, he's gonna be turning the corner in a moment. If we get a sneak attack on him, yeah, just like that. Oh, he will not be dissuaded from his rounds. There we go. I was never too good at Battlezone. Something that you can kind of do that's kind of cool is you can still... Okay, alright. Oh god. Dodge. Because I can't take much damage. But one thing is that if you keep pushing forwards but just slightly turn the stick a little bit, you're not turning with the stick. You're just trying to get it to not point up. And if you do that, it makes turning make a little bit more sense. Not that it doesn't make sense, but it's just not what I'm used to. Because I don't drive tanks very often. Turn around. Because he's going to be coming in just a moment. Yes!
Nice work, Barry. That should cool down those mercenaries for a while.
First try. Alright, Alright, now we play Bentley. It's time for more war crimes. Let's go fill Moomin Valley with war crimes. What's everyone up to? I think we're making good timing on this.
Yeah, dude.
We're already... Wow. Ooh. Okay, that's cool. Because for as long as these have been the past couple streams, we're only at the hour and a half mark, and we're already on our way to, like, the final operation. So, that's nice. Oh, I guess there was a slide now. I heart crime. Me when I first signed up for Tumblr. Whoops. 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 See you later. Nope, you got the wrong guy. Sorry. Bentley, more like couldn't been me. Tris, I'm probably not going to, if I'm honest, during the stream, because I'm trying to play the game and I'm trying to not have it take all night this time. Given that, you know, Kebby has school in the morning, and you probably have school in the morning. So I'd like to just get through the episode.
I couldn't have done anything wrong. I'm just a silly little guy who
definitely does not commit war crimes.
Power. According to General Clawfoot, a mobile energy source is stored at the end of this hallway.
Hallway is a pretty kind term for what looks to me like a complex medieval gauntlet of death.
Yes. Well, while the idea of jumping down a crypt filled with whirling, razor-sharp spikes might scare me, in fact, terrorized by every fiber, it's the only way to power up that old computer in the re-education tower. Without that thing online, we'll never get at the Clockwork Eyes or free Carmelita.
You're a good man, Bentley. Just make sure those traps don't rip you into 100 little turtle pieces.
Why'd you have to say that?
You forgot Sticky. Alright. You have to wait until they hit the one side, I think.
Damn it!
I went too early. It's a good thing I have plot armor. Oh, shit. Ooh, wow, that was close. Who the fuck built any of this? And what for? Other than plot reasons, of course. These are some complex-ass spike traps, dude. Fuck. Okay, there we go. Hit it. Water. A turtle's most fearsome enemy. Boom.
Aha! This acid battery should do the trick. Just walk close to the electrode and...
He's a tortoise. He'd die.
Prepare to be hacked, you knave.
Alright, now we get to the part that I'm actually good at. First try.
I'll get you, Contessa.
He can't swim.
How many times must you say that? It's not going to happen.
I'm dead serious. I'll get you.
I'll get you. I'll get you.
I mean it. I'll get you.
Yes, yes. So I've heard.
That's one down, two to go. I had better not take any damage while carrying this battery to the other terminals. It is, after all, filled with acid.
There you go, it's a lead acid battery.
Ready for another session of hacking mastery.
That's okay, because I couldn't take any damage anyway.
Dude, I need some acid right now, I guess.
Okay, ready for another session of hacking mastery.
See, man, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do this in one shot. That looks pretty, pretty intimidating. But at least the hard part should be coming first. If it was easy and got harder at the beginning. Oh no, this is the one that sucks the hardest. My bad. Come on.
First try. First try, gamers.
Okay, ready for another session of hacking mastery.
This is the one that sucks the fucking hardest. Oh god. Whoo! Shit! Wow! Holy fuck. I didn't expect to survive that. Alright. Hack time. Dude, the hack music gets funkier every time. I want to hear a drum and bass remix of this. This kind of actually reminds me of some of the stuff I was doing with Soundbox, which was like an online tracker thing. I might still have those. At the very least, I have the renders of them. I intended them for like a little like outtakes compilation that I was going to call Messy Things. I still have the album art. I need to actually put that out. I actually need to put out enough music to justify an outtakes compilation.
should approach this through your id instead of your conscious mind. It might help to get around your super ego.
She just called her big-headed egomaniac.
One more computer.
Which is true.
Get out of here.
Don't get me wrong. But you know, it's not a very nice thing to call somebody. I'm pretty sure that the double meaning was intended. Because obviously there's the id, the ego, superego, but I feel like that was a double. I felt like there was a pun. It was what we in the trade call a double entendre, if you excuse the slight bit of French. I'm still gonna do a first try. First try. Oh my god, it's a boss. Fuck. Of course, the one time where I actually say I'm gonna do a first try, I don't. I make myself look like a fucking idiot. That's okay. If there's one thing working retail has taught me, it is how to handle embarrassment gracefully. So I'll just say that was totally intended. Absolutely. First try.
Fox, why fight it? Don't you want to be my
friend? Why fight it?
No, you horrible eight-legged cow. No.
With that old computer powered up, my work here is done.
How nice of her, really. I mean, imagine what she can do with those eight legs. That's all I'm saying. Seven vaginas. Absolutely fucked up in the crib. Seven Vegumenas. I quite like that that's the same truck that keeps appearing in all of the levels. It's just like this piece of repeating decoration that just appears all over the place because it fits in every single level. Like, seriously, I don't think there's been a level yet that hasn't had that truck. Maybe Prague 1. Amazon will ship anywhere. It's true. Ah, Z fighting. Actually, well, it's not really Z fighting, but it is a polygon sorting issue. Ah, I guess I should probably move before I get blown up into sticky turtle chunks. Nope. See you later. Clipping. There you go. Clipping. What he said. Listen to him. He's very smart. He's the smartest boy I know, okay? And he likes rum.
Sticky turtle chunks sounds like a dish.
I'd try it.
And hook it up for our side, giving us control over Neela's mercenaries. Sounds great.
You'll have to steal a few keys here or there to get access to the more secure areas of the castle.
If there's pockets to be picked, I'm your man.
First, steal a wiretap and the voice modulator. Then head for the sewers beneath Neela's headquarters.
I'm on it.
Yoink. Can we do the other one too? Bentley is so silly. It's to, oops. Shit. It's all a ploy. It's all a distraction. Perfect. That's exactly what I want to see. Whoops. See, Sly is a master thief. I'm a fucking amateur. But yeah, no. Bentley's voice is all a distraction. To make you think that he's just a silly little guy. While he, you know. Something war crimes.
Touched his butt.
Smooth work. Now use those keys to break into the castle and get at that wiretap.
I mean, to be fair, Sly has tapped literally everybody's ass at this point. Guards, Contessa, Rajan. If there is a man who appreciates the back door, it is Sly. Maybe that's a little violent. Maybe there's some like innocent people in this town who probably shouldn't get literally carpet bombed. Maybe that's a little much. Thank you. I mean, I guess Neela doesn't really care, but you know, I do. Win merge on system 32. When was the last time you visited the chess club? You dork.
The wire pal?
Totally. That's absolutely. That's totally 100% my MO here. To be honest, it's probably a good thing that I picked a fight, because, I need health.
Would you like to start one?
Oh yeah, that wiretap is perfect.
That is a fine piece of ass. A wiretap.
Alright.
No! Stop grabbing the spires. I want to use the hooks. Gotta get back up there. Thinking about it, I should be good for next Sunday. I said earlier in the stream that I might not be able to make Sundays going forwards because of this job that I'm potentially going to get. I think I'm pretty safe in it at this point. I just need to get in the actual physical interview. But, oh, why did I fuck? Ugh. How could things get any worse? Good grief. But yeah, so, I'm definitely not going to be working next Sunday, so I should be able to. I'll see what they say about scheduling, because I imagine my schedule is going to be a little funky anyway, thanks to, training and whatnot. So.
What worked?
Oh, DZB legit wants to, learn chess. He legit wants to start at the Somnol Chess Club. That's adorable. I appreciate it. I like that they sleep like doggies on rooftops, too. That's pretty cute. Okay, come on. Keys, please.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not surprised that worked.
If it's not working, then the solution is probably, to make it work. I hope that's not, too technical of an explanation, but... Apparently there's supposed to be another guard somewhere? Oh, there he is. I love that they have guards spawning up here. They literally just get knocked right off the roof and die. Hey, whoa. Damn it. And there we go. He goes right back to not caring. Thank you, thank you.
Nice job. Through with the voice modulator.
Vulture can't fly. Where are we supposed to go? Oh, can we pickpocket the Eepy Doggy? We can. That's great. Oh, it's right here. Perfect. Easy does it. You just gotta make some noise. Alright, listen, it's a tough world out there. It's kill or be slaughtered. They wouldn't find me very cute, even though I'm a raccoon. Voice modulator.
That's it. You've got the Contessa's voice modulator. Let's go put that thing to work.
Oh, yeah. Let's fucking go. They're both in the same spot. Could you theoretically fail this mission by having the bombers hit the birds?
Easy does it.
That's some quality thieving, Sly. Now head for the runoff drains near the riverside.
I'm so glad that Bentley gives me praise and a warm motherly voice for completing the tasks that he has instructed me to partake in. I very much appreciate that. I need constant positive reinforcement. I am a sad sack of shit. Alright, sewer time, boyos.
You'll need to crawl through one of
Bentley's actually the one reprogramming you. Also, by the way, I have a girlfriend. I don't need Bentley for that, but I appreciate the thought. Poor Bentley. First we say he's committing war crimes, and then we say he's like... oh god. Why is it so electrified down here? It's a sewer! This must be the Contessa's doing. She knows the Cooper gang's ways. Looks like we got lucky.
The Contessa's men have already excavated Mila's satellite cable. How should I proceed?
It's okay, he has Murray. Listen, we support Turtle, Pippo, Gay Love. We do. This is going to be so cool. He can tell Murray he's a good boy. Murray actually would appreciate it, I'm sure. Totally believable. Makes things awkward in the van when they're getting hot and heavy. They have to pull over to the side.
It's time to wage war on the castle, and in the confusion, pull off a heist I've named Operation High Road. First, Murray will take down the spotlights on the main gate with the codes provided by General Clawfoot.
Now he's a VTuber? Poor bastard. We're just humiliating. I'm sorry, apparently he's a tortoise.
Sly will then paraglide the two of us over to the Contessa's getaway blimp, and we'll use it to get inside her re-education tower.
Her re-education... Hold on.
Undoubtedly draw the re-education tower.
Post. And if we free Inspector Fox... She's sure to clear out the Contessa. With the Mind Shuffler exposed, I'll plant the bad mojo bomb, and presto, the clockwork eyes are ours. So if the two of you are ready, let's take our positions and get this thing started.
All right. Ever since I've come back, I can't do the Phil Thomas cat voice. I'm sorry. I'm gonna have to practice it. We were, what we're doing to Bentley is potatoes to what we were doing to Phil Thomas' cat. Oh, that's all I'm saying. You are all really cool. I need to listen. I do. Listen, Phil Thomas' cat was in constant rotation when I was in Wales. All right. It was hard to beat Welfare Wednesdays at the Enterprise Room. That was it, the Enterprise Room. Welfare Wednesdays being where the drinks are really, really cheap and where you can find presumably fantastic women.
I hope that general guy told the truth or this is gonna get ugly. Oh yeah! The lights are down, Bentley. Time to call in the cavalry. I'll see if I can find some extra firepower to help out.
Attention, bloodthirsty mercenary forces! The castle
defenses are down. Seize this opportunity for aggressive military action by pressing an attack on the castle. Charge for victory, for glory.
That should do it.
That should do it.
Now that you're done being a warmonger, feel like paragliding over to that blimp?
Just make sure to grab the rope hanging off that thing. I don't want to drown.
Oh, he's giving him a piggyback ride. That's adorable.
This could get rough.
Oh, God.
Education Tower.
Alright, here we go. Who's gonna end up on the whatever the he called the table next? Take your bets. Place your bets.
Take your pick.
What? The mercenaries have breached the castle defenses? All of you go! Defend this tower to the last man!
For victory, for glory.
Don't worry, my dear. I still have time to finish with your readjustment.
Let me out of here and I'll readjust your face.
Wink wonk.
Okay, partner. Looks like the Shadow Guard is out of the picture. You ready to free our violent little princess?
Affirmative. That Iron Tech 250 is...
Iron Tech 250, there we go.
Access to Carbolita's restraints has to be in this old terminal somewhere.
I assume this is where we adjust the shackles. Personally, I think hooking up to a computer system takes a little bit of the fun out of it, but hey. You access the inflation hose. Doink! She's free! Get your blaster ready.
I've isolated the brain pattern. You and I are about to
get the ball stretcher.
Okay, new best friend. Hands up! And I mean all of them.
My dear, you really should... Shadow Guard!
You let her. You had her.
Here, you witch.
Ah, dude, her aim with that blaster sucks cock.
Problems with the shock pistol.
She is rather truculent. Stand clear,
Slade. I have no idea what truculent means. Did I just learn a new word?
Bentley, you okay?
This is no place for an asthmatic, but I've located one of the clockwork eyes. Can you find the other?
How is he breathing at all? Asthma or not?
Safely in hand.
Neela?
Thanks for clearing out the Contessa. Nothing I did could pry her away from the clockwork eyes. One should be enough for the old bird.
Aggressively hostile bird.
Thank you, guys. Very interesting.
Bentley, take the eye and escape on the blimp. I'm going after Neela.
But the plan, this wasn't in the plan.
Yeah, Sly, how very dare you break with the plan, the capital P plan. She's truculent and succulent.
Focus your attack on the contestant's blimp.
Heads up, Bentley, you're about to come under fire. Get to the blimp's turret and stay sharp.
Fuck. You messed with his schedule. He's asthmatic and autistic. How dare?
Attention all bombers.
There's really, like, not much room to... Oh.
Heads up, Bentley. You're about to come under fire. Get to the blimp's turret and stay sharp.
Alright, where's she landing? Fuck. There we go. Isn't it funny that Sly is slightly faster than Cider? I don't know why I can't just whack the shit out of her with my cane, but, you know, reasons. Oh god. I cannot read chat in this state. I'm sorry. anybody is saying anything, I have no idea. Ow! Jesus, take my head off, why don't you? Oh, fuck. I missed that jump. I have no idea where she went.
Wait.
Hold on. Okay, alright. I thought my video went out again. Alright, come on.
Attention all bombers. Focus your attack on the Contessa's blimp.
Heads up, Bentley. You're about to come under fire. Get to the blimp's turret and stay sharp.
Well, I'm not moving out. It wasn't far off. She can hit the barrels, but I can't. Jeez. First try, we got it, gamers. We got it. First try. Just like we always do. She's stuck in the web.
You really should watch where you're going. This place is dangerous.
That cheeky fuck.
Don't you dare. That eye is mine. It's mine.
Actually,
Mr. Cooper, the eye belongs to me.
All right, time to fight the spider. Wow, Kinky, both the female cat. Where's the dudes? Where's the fairness? Alright, so I have to take down a bunch of bombers? Okay. Yep. Let's freaking go. Ow. Will this be a first try? I actually have no idea. I can be good at this game sometimes, and I can suck at this game sometimes.
That's just not safe.
Oh shit. Yes, first try. First try.
The guidance system, and the blimp's descending at a decidedly unsafe rate. I'm going down, down, down.
Yeah, indeed. They totally took out the scene of Bentley going down.
belongs to me, and I want it.
I fucked that joke up.
No way. You think I'm crazy? Actually, on second thought, don't answer that. I really don't want your professional opinion.
Not crazy, just stupid. You're an ignorant child playing dress up in his father's legacy. Oh, I know all about you and the Cooper clan.
Then you'll understand why this eye needs to be destroyed.
Short-sighted fool! I've no interest in your narrow interpretation of morality. I'm above all that. Above good and evil.
And you think I'd give the eye to someone that's above morality?
Enough talk, insect. It will be just
She's literally an insect,
and
though.
More fun to pry it from your cold, dead hand.
Alrighty, let's go. Wow. Big whap. All seven whaps. Don't be bug. Okay, so I have now been, bird racist, bat racist, and bug racist. We need more bee species that I could be racist to. I'm on a roll here. I'm on a roll tonight. Oh, I'm so glad Bentley survived. Oh shit. So I guess Bentley gave up one of the eyes. It's true. Racism, the racism set on retro achievements, I'm going for it. Doink. First try.
Enough. You've shown me the error of my ways.
I feel sorry for you. All your education and you still don't know right from wrong. Huh? Oof!
I know enough not to let my guard down around an intellectually superior opponent.
Well, I guess now both of the eyes are gone.
She's got the eye!
How's this thing work? What's this do? And this?
Guys, help! Carmelita took the eye, and she's trying to get away in one of the Contessa's tanks!
Don't worry about it, little buddy. I won't let her get away.
More tank controls? Really?
Shoot at her tank and keep on shelling her to stop that tank!
Oh, God. You should know better than to put me in a fucking tank. Oh, motherfucker. I wasn't trained for this. Alright, I was trained for very simple, very straightforward shooting games. They're more reflexes than anything, not fucking tank controls. I was never good at Battlezone. I still can't play Battlezone. I'm sure Battlezone is easier, frankly. Come on. Yeah, come on. Oh, almost? Hey Ryan, what's up? This is Bro's Naughty Forklift Certified. I'm having a whale of a time right now.
How's this thing work? What's this do? And this?
Guys, help! Carmelita took the eye, and she's trying to get away in one of the Contessa's tanks!
Don't worry about it, little buddy. I won't let her get away.
Okay, come on. Let's actually make this happen.
Shoot at her tank, Dan. Keep on telling her to stop that tank.
There we go. I was literally one shot off last time.
Still stuck in her tank. Then come around to pick up Bentley for a quick exit. Do what you can, Sly. We'll all hook up at the rendezvous for extraction.
There's nowhere left to run. We both know I can beat you in a fight. So why don't you just hand over the eye?
You're right, Cooper. In a battle of strength, you've proven yourself. But with this clockwork eye, I can battle in your mind.
Oh. She's using the eye as a weapon. That sure does check out. It's pretty easy to avoid the line of sight of the eye, but do you guys want to see what happens if you don't? I'll show you real quick. It's pretty fun. Trained in guerrilla warfare.
Yo. Yo.
I love it. He goes all stupid. Girls have that effect, if I'm honest. Oh wow, she actually like lassos you back up. That's pretty cool. Squashed. Again.
You've got a strong mind, Cooper. I never would have guessed.
Aye. Well, his are closed. We got the tickles. We got the things hypnosis. Exactly plan, we got the tying up Carmelita. I just got it all. Listen. We are effectively worse.
The Contessa
than
was arrested and brought to trial for the crime she committed while working for Interpol. Their PR damage control went one step further by promoting Neela, the hero of Prague, to the rank of captain. Carmelita, still on the outs with Interpol, had to run with the rest of us. To my surprise and eternal delight, I got to help my favorite policewoman escape from the cops.
Hey.
I tried to put it all out of my mind. This claw business was spiraling out of control, and I knew that my gang was at the center of it. We'd be back in action soon enough, but for now, well, we just laid low for a while.
And there we go. It's another episode down. We did it in a much, much shorter stream than last time, like a good 45 minutes shorter, which I'm very happy about. So, yee! Next episode, we go to the north. Kind of wondering if we should go back for some of the bottles. Oh, that's cool. Look, they even tell you how long it took. So we did France in an hour and a half. India 1 in an hour and 15 minutes. India 2 in an hour and 47 minutes. Prague 1 took like 2 hours. And then this one took Also almost 2 hours. Wow, that was a fast 2 hours. That really felt a whole lot faster than last time. That's cool. Yeah, sure, Tris, I'll check that out. I guess, if you guys want to have me put it on stream.
Yeah, more content, less suffering,
despite my issues with some of the traps. But, hey, I like a good trap. So,
I missed the bonus video.
That's right, I did just see that. Hold on. I don't remember which one it was under. I think it was 3. It might have been 2. Prog 1. Okay. Let's see. I'm trying to figure out how you trigger it again. Jesus. Maybe it was France. Who knows? It's random or on a timer, I think. Sounds about right. Yeah, I can't seem to get it to trigger again, unfortunately. I did see it, though, in the replay, because, of course, I see my stream on my phone. I saw it in the replay, but, unfortunately, I cannot get it to trigger again. That is a shame. I feel like that's probably a good place to call it, though. We can have a shorter stream, you know? There's no reason that we have to go for 2.5 hours every single time. Or 3, or, you know, however long. It's such a shame about the bonus video, though. Yeah, I give up on that. That's all right, though. Good times. That was a cool stream. I'm gonna go ahead and check out what Tris posted real quick. Maybe we could chat for a little bit. Who knows? That's tiny. I can't show that on stream. That's so small. Fucking gotta squint to see him. The Murray one's pretty great, though. We were coming up with names for them because if Bentley is Hitler, we've decided Murray is Mussolini, and Sly is Stalin. So, oh shit, yeah, sure, I'll hop into
Friday's stream in a moment. If you want to throw the link into chat, then that's perfectly fine. But I'm just winding down here and resting my legs, because I don't know if you guys know this, I do these streams standing up, so that's why I probably sound a little bit distant from my mic, because quite literally I am. It's sitting on my bed as I stand in front of my TV, because I currently have my TV set up on a very tall dresser, and it's really not ideal for actually sitting and playing games, because if you try to sit down, my TV... See, we're spoiled in the 21st century of 2024. We have, you know, nice IPS displays that look good from any angle. And although I do like my old Emerson TV, it's a shitty TN display. I think it's TN, where the colors get all funky if you look at it from the side. So, you know, that's just how it happens. It's a nice TV. Other than that, it's from that very early stage of HDTVs where they have all the hookups. So you get your component, you get your S video, which is actually really nice if I'm playing PS1 games, because that's the PS2 will send 240p over component, but it won't, like, my capture device will take it, but my TV doesn't. I think it says like mismatched format or something. Unfortunately, or in unsupported display type or something like that. See, they would think it's black magic. They would think it's bad mojo. And then you would go into the old Ironside T250, and then they would chop your head off. So I maybe will hold back on going back in time to show medieval serfs video games. But yeah, it's got all the hookups you could want. It's got a VGA in. It'll do all that nice shit. So theoretically, actually, if I wanted to, I could... Well, it's not a very good HDMI display because the overscan is fucking awful on it. Or I guess you would call it underscan because it cuts off parts of the picture. I like the TV. I like it. It's not perfect, but I would much rather have its warts than have no fucking hookups, which is the problem with all these goddamn smart TVs that you can buy nowadays, where all they have is HDMI and maybe composites. Oftentimes, it's quite literally just HDMI and maybe an antenna hookup. Sometimes they give you composite, you know, which is effectively like... giving you a reach around after sticking a bag dragon up your ass, which I don't appreciate. I want the hookups, please, you know. And meanwhile, in the UK, they've been living goddamn large for decades now, because all their hookups supported fucking SCART, all their TVs and all their old consoles and stuff, so they were getting RGB quality output out of the PS1 when the PS1 was new, you know. We didn't get any of that shit. It just wasn't a thing on our TVs, so... but that's just me rambling aside, especially since I gotta... I'll be thinking about these things more as I eventually move to Wales in, like, the next 5 years. It's pretty crazy to think that in the next 5 years I will be living in another country, you know? That it is rapidly coming up on the horizon, you know? It's just crazy to think about. I was talking about this in the car the other day. The idea of my life, sort of a very specific era of my life, because you have like the first 18 years of my life, right, which is like, you know, you're in school, and I knew Savannah at least, but I was Pringle and Brianna and all those fucking people, it was, I'm weirdly fond of it now, but it was not a good time, you know. It's just that kind of thing where time heals all the wounds and makes everything look rosier than it was. But, you know, I really was thinking about that the other day. I'm like, man, maybe I miss just, like, not having... Maybe I miss isolation a little bit. I don't know. Maybe that's what I've been feeling lately. But you got that. Then I meet Kevy, and then Somnolescence starts. And that has continued. And also, you know, the lockdowns and stuff. So that was, I would say, 18 to, like, 20... It's still ongoing. I'm in the same bedroom. I'm doing the same things as I was doing. But
a new era of my life will be starting in the next 5 years, and that is absolutely crazy. You know, it's not something that it's something that I'm looking forward to, but it's not something I would have ever expected to happen. And there's not a day that goes by that I don't fucking miss Wales. You know, that's all right though. We carry on. So I'm probably gonna call it there. I do see that we have peaked at 7 viewers. People keep popping in and out. I don't know if that's just Streamlabs being inaccurate or what. Let's check my YouTube dash. 5 concurrent viewers, it says that one, and Streamlabs now says 8. And now YouTube Studio says 8. Well, sorry you guys see all of this right at the very end. The VOD will be available in a bit. So you'll be able to watch it then. How is stream health? It's always been excellent. My internet is so much better than it used to be. But yeah. So I'm going to call it there for the night. Thank you guys again for tuning in. And I will let you know if anything comes up as far as scheduling goes. Because I might have to move these to another day, which is, you know, unfortunate. Because everybody's been settled into this. But I don't really think I'm at the point where, like, I have a consistent enough audience for when I do it to matter. Yeah, it was a good stream. And I will say that is probably one of my favorite episodes of Sly 2, is Prog 2. It's very, very good mood, pretty easy to navigate, some memorable objectives, more so than, like, Prog 1 or... Prog 1 was okay. I would say India was kind of a low point. But yeah. Thanks everyone for showing up. Thanks for people for chatting. I will be seeing you next week. Thanks for watching.